some more heavy lifting. Let's talk about the distributed data structures that GMS has in order to do this virtual memory management across the entire cluster. First thing that GMS has to do is to convert a virtual address, which is a local thing so far as a single process is concerned, and convert that virtual address into a global identifier, or what we'll call as the universal ID. And the way we derive the universal ID from the virtual address is fairly straightforward if you think about it. We know which node this virtual address emanated from, IP address. We know which disk partition contains a copy of the page that corresponds to this virtual address, that we know. What is the inode data structure that corresponds to this page? And what is the offset? So if you put all of these entities together, you get a universal ID that uniquely identifies a virtual address. This is the offset within a page. So given a virtual address, the first three parts uniquely identify the page, and the fourth part identifies the offset within that page for that virtual address. And this, we can derive it from the virtual memory system as well as the UBC. There are three key data structures, PFD, GCD, and POD. These three data structures are the workhorses that make this cluster-wide memory management possible. Let's talk about each one of these things. PFD is like a page table. Normally in a page table, what you do is you give it a virtual address and the page table says, oh, I know what is the physical frame that backs this particular virtual address. That is the translation between a virtual page number and the physical page frame that hosts that virtual page is contained in a page table. Similar to that, this PFD, it's called the page frame directory. It has a mapping between an UID, because your virtual address has been converted to a UID. Given a UID, it says, what is the page frame that backs that particular UID? That's this data structure. Because we're doing cluster-wide memory management, the page itself can be in one of four different states. It could be in the local part of that node, and if it is in the local part of a node, then that page could be a private page, or it could be a shared page. These are two possibilities if it is living in the local part of the physical memory of a node. If it is in the global part, we know by definition, global part is only hosting clean pages. So the content of global cache is always going to be private pages. And so the state of the page that happens to be in the global cache of a particular node is guaranteed to be a private state. And the last possibility is that it's not in the physical memory of a node, but it is on the disk. So the page frame directory, just like a page table, says that either this page that you're looking for, go from VA to UID, that page is in physical memory and it is one of these three states, or it's not in the physical memory, it's on the disk.